won't come out to play.
Hey, this is Jeff. Yeah, you remember that happy-go-lucky guy? The one you told about his two-faced cheating slut of a wife?
I just took some photos. But yeah, how you doing now anyway? You leave that bitch?
You can say I cut some ties. Meet me at the garage off Silicon Street at the northeast corner of Middle Park. I need your help.
I need the discard.
What's going on?
Yeah, I got a bit of a problem. A bit of a big fucking problem.
What's going on?
Yeah, Jeff really did it this time. Jeff went too far. Jeff's been a bad boy, a really bad boy.
What are you saying, lunatic?
Remember my wife, Shirley? She had an accident in the kitchen.
What kind of an accident?
Oh, the kind of accident where you stab yourself 50 fucking times with a kitchen knife. You fucking whore. Fuck my friend, will you? Well, who's laughing now, bitch? Huh? Not you, you fucking dead whore.
Hey, buddy. Whoa, calm down.
Hey, fuck you.
Don't be an idiot. What do you want me to do?
Get rid of her and get rid of the car, hey?
Okay, but it's going to cost you. $5,000.
Sure, whatever.
Give me the keys. Put the gun away.
Okay, thanks. Oh, Jeff really messed up this time, didn't he? Oh.
Get out of here.
Yeah.
World's about to end.
Born in the ghetto, it's hard to survive. Sometimes I think that many brothers try, but I realize which life to choose.
Too long, television talk shows have been the domain of women, clucking like hens on things they know nothing about. Now, on Weasel, television finally gets manly again. Baz Rudin.
I don't believe in an eye for eye. Oh, no, because Boss believes in an eye for two eyes, or better yet, an eye for two eyes and an ear and a spleen. And maybe a new shirt, because this one is covered in entrails.
Jeremy, tune in only on Weasel.
Dumb sounds in a dumb city.